Ladies and gentlemen, 23rd July 2014, the biggest celebration in my family because I, the sole son, had got into IBA, and not just into IBA, but the coveted BBA program at IBA. Fast forward 1 year, 23rd July 2015, the biggest, baddest fight in my family because the sole son who had got into IBA's coveted BBA program had decided to transfer to the social sciences program. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, because I want to pursue a career in history, Islamic history, and let me tell you why. I was born a Muslim. I wanted to know what was Islam. So I went to Peshawar and I saw the massacre of 150 young children and I heard a voice, this is Islam. Then I went to Seymour Sharif and I saw mystics dancing and revolving and prostrating in front of graves and I heard a voice, this is Islam. And then I went to Makkah in Medina and I saw graves being pummeled over by tanks and I heard a voice, this is Islam. Then I went to Kabul and I saw the Taliban beating up a man for not having a beard and I heard a voice, this is Islam. And then I went to Karachi and I saw young people drinking alcohol, partying and dancing. And I was told that yes, this is also Islam. And I was confused. And I wanted to know if this is Islam, then who am I? Who is a Muslim? And what is Islam? Is there one Islam? Or are all of these Islam? And ladies and gentlemen, how does that relate to my change of program? It relates in this sense because in my first year at IBA, or in my second year at IBA, I took a couple of history courses. And in those history courses, I came across an essay from a book called Islam, Fundamentalism and the Betrayal of Tradition by Professor Joseph Lombard of Yale University. And he wrote an essay. He wrote an essay called The Decline of Knowledge and the Rise of Ideology in the Modern Islamic World. And in that essay, he showed how the Ehsani tradition, which was a modern form of Sufism, how it was taken over by the colonialist power and how that discourse completely changed what we thought of Islam. So some people thought that this was Islam and others thought this was Islam. And that is why, ladies and gentlemen, we have to rescue our history from the colonialist discourse, because our history, the history that we have received, we received through the lenses of the British. Let me give you a very quick example which will tell you why this is so important for Muslims to study history. Bilal Habshi, an Abyssinian or a black person. When we think of Bilal, we think of a black slave, but Bilal Habshi was an Abyssinian. It was the Orientalist discourse where the category of black was thought in terms of races, which is why we inherited that category and we thought of the Abyssinian slave as black. And this is why, ladies and gentlemen, I want to pursue a career in Islamic history.